today, as we're talking, it's considered a cancer that can't be eliminated, can't be cured. But I think it might be I know it's a cancer that can be controlled for longer periods of time today than 20 years ago, and patients are living longer and better. But it's still not a long time. I mean, it's a few years, 1 to 2 years is how long most patients live after a diagnosis of glioblastoma. If we could turn that into 5 or 10 years, that would be important. That would be an important step forward. Because this is a cancer that I don't think we're going to treat more effectively by being lucky. And I don't think it's a cancer that we're going to be able to manage more effectively by some fairly simple preventative measure. It's not clear how one would prevent getting this illness. It doesn't seem to be related to lifestyle or other factors, smoking, diet, exercise, lots of it or lack of it, thinking hard or thinking not so hard. It's not clear how you would prevent this illness. Well, glioblastoma is uncommon, relatively uncommon, thankfully, compared to lung cancer, breast cancer, colon cancer, prostate cancer. Those would be the big four cancers that we struggle with as a society. And so we have in the laboratory a model of the patient's disease, and then we can study it in ways that weren't possible before. So those cells are kind of the essence of the project, and then we team up with people in Toronto who do have the capability of testing thousands of compounds on cells in a short period of time to discover new drugs or old drugs that will find a new purpose in the treatment of glioblastoma. That's the goal. And then these same cells can be sequenced at the Genome Sciences Center in Vancouver so that we can know in fine detail their molecular nature. So that's the idea, to harness the talent that is resident in these centers to discover new treatments for glioblastoma. Of course, we talk about the goal of the Terry Fox is having a drug or two in clinical trials in the next 2 to 3 years. 5 years is the mandate of the project, but we hope that we would have an interesting new drug or two in the clinic within a couple of years. But that's just a short-term thing. I mean, the long-term goal is to have a steady stream of very interesting new treatments for brain cancer coming to our clinics on a yearly basis. Every 6 months, there's something new that we're trying and testing. Some of them, we hope, will be highly useful. If not in everyone with glioblastoma, then in some people with glioblastoma. Some might be used on their own, some might be twinned with other things that are useful. But we imagine a pipeline of discovery from labs to the clinic that quickly translate the things we learn in the realm of science to things that are helpful in the clinic. And we all want to accelerate this process of discovery and the process of translation to real benefit for patients with these serious problems. So the goal of the project is to develop new compounds and to test them in our clinics and make a difference to patients. We'd love to cure the illness, but even if we control it for several years longer than we do currently, that would be a big step forward.